Hey there, friends. Thanks for checking in. Just yesterday, Tuesday, July 13th, the Fourth Circuit Appeals Court in Virginia voted on a 2-1 margin that young adults ages 18 to 21 have been prohibited from purchasing a handgun. That law has been around since 1968, and they said that's a violation of the Second Amendment. We hand these young adults sidearms. We teach them how to use a rifle. We send them off to war. But yet, on our own homeland, they cannot practice those same rights of defense with a firearm. And so this court, the appeals court, in a bold move said, no, we're actually going to expand the Second Amendment in this case, and we are going to make it so that that is no longer a prohibition against young adults. Now, this was brought to the court by two young people under the age of 21, a male and a female. Now, the female said that she had an abusive ex who was violating restraining order, and she felt intimidated, scared, and fearful of her life. She said she also had a job that took her around people, away from the main population, and she felt vulnerable. I'm not sure what the young man's story was, but he was part of that suit as well. And so what do you have? You have people who are going to do what they always do. The naysayers, the anti-gunners, they're going to say, it's going to be chaos. We want less guns, not more guns. We hear that all the time. Well, kind of late for that. We set record levels of gun sales the last year and a half. And, you know, trust me, your society now has more guns. But they do that. I heard the same rhetoric when so many people were getting their CCW permits. They were saying, it's going to be like the Wild West. People are going to be shooting each other. They're going to get mad. They're going to act on emotion. They say that, and not much has really happened in terms of increased crime because law-abiding people. So often, you turn on the news or you read an article and you hear about some 16, 17, 18-year-old kid committing violence with a firearm. And yet our own law-abiding citizens, ages 18 to 21, they can't own, 18 to 20, can't own a handgun. Which, by the way, is the most concealable firearm that you could use for carry. Okay, I think that's indisputable. They can't do that. They say you're allowed to buy a shotgun, you're allowed to buy a rifle at the age of 18, but you can't buy a handgun. Well, this Fourth Circuit said enough of that, no more prohibiting these young adults from exercising their Second Amendment. All other constitutional rights are protected for these people except the Second Amendment. And you know what? We're going to end that right now. I couldn't be happier. Now, if anybody out here is watching this saying, you know what? I don't think this is a good idea because I'm worried that these kids are going to misuse their firearm, then that's anti-2A. Anything that expands the Second Amendment it has to be viewed as a positive thing. Now, where this will go, I don't think anybody knows because it's already said that that ruling is going to get appealed and it could make its way all the way to the Supreme Court. And I hope it does. Let's get this on the table now. It's almost like when these liberal politicians want to implement gun control, which, by the way, violence prevention is the new word for gun control. All right, you're going to see that. They're going to say, you know, we're going to create this bill. It's going to be called violence prevention. And everybody wants to say, oh, violence prevention. I'm for that. What are they going to do? Are they going to stop the rioting? Are they going to stop the looting? Are they going to stop buildings on fire? No, it's a cozy way of saying gun control. But every time they do this, they think of negative things of what could happen. They take every benefit of self-protection out of the equation, and they blame people. They blame like you, they blame me, they blame the psychotic gun people every single time, and yet we don't see increased levels of gun violence with the law abiding. We see it with criminals all the time. So it's a good thing. We shouldn't sit back and say it's going to be dangerous. We should allow these people to, and we should respect their Second Amendment rights, as this Fourth Circuit Appeals Court did, and say, you know what, let's expand the Second Amendment. We heard the same thing with suppressors. We did. Oh, they're going to be shooting all over the place. Nobody knows where the bullets are going to come. I heard that all the time. Where are the bullets coming from? We haven't seen an increase in gun violence with suppressors or anything else. So that's where it is. You know, we'll see. I hope it goes to the Supreme Court. Let's get it out. Let's get it on the table. Let's get talking about it. And let's let these politicians do what they're going to do, whine like a bunch of little babies. And in the meantime, I'm hoping that these young adults will be able to finally purchase handguns. If you like videos like this, please subscribe and share. I always appreciate the thumbs up button. Thanks for watching, and you guys be safe.